Hello and welcome everybody, and thank you guys for joining me again. My name is Wolkie and I'm here with another Lost Ark guide. Today's topic is going to be my Lancemaster, more specifically for two skill builds that I use for chaos and mobbing and the other one that I use for raids and voids. Before you actually go over the skills, there's one thing that I'd like to mention, and that is my engraving. I do use Superiority of the Stars. Fret not though, if you don't have this available because you're just new to the game or you don't really know how they work, the build is going to be working 100% exactly the same for you, because this engraving doesn't actually change the way any of the mechanics work, it just buffs up the effectiveness. So in case you're new to the Lancemaster or you don't know what her identity does, she has these three cells at the bottom that she fills up. If we take that one, these fill over time or when you hit mobs. So let's just summon a few mobs. So dealing damage to enemies fills this bar up. And by switching, whenever one, two, or all the three cells are up, you will get a buff that will give you increased stats. Both sun stands and moon stands, these are what the stands are called, have a different buff. But the engraving only increases the amount of stats they give. So even if you don't have any engraving, the effect is going to be the same, just a little bit weaker. So with that out of the way, first build is going to be... let's remove that. First build is going to be my Chaos Dungeon mobbing build. Moonblade Fury, very straightforward. Yes, very straightforward skill. Mobility tool, you definitely want that... let me remove that. You definitely want that tripod here, because without the tripod, this is what the skill looks like. It's not really that impressive, but 4 skill points for another mobility tool and to make it a little bit faster is definitely worth it. Short cooldown, I use it to proc my bleed. Definitely an option there. Fine to use. Flying Blue Dragon is a resource builder. While the skill looks rather flashy, especially if you get the waves of energy and stuff, it's not really such a hard-hitting skill, so personally I just use it to build resource. Has a decent animation, has like a two-part animation, so it has like a forward dash, and if you don't use anything you do this backstep, and if you keep on using it you can also change direction like this, so you can play around a little bit with it. But like I said, just a resource builder, so we take synergy to build Luminevers faster. Descent of the Moon, pure mobility skill, so if you have those 4 skill points left over, definitely take it so you can move around a little bit further. Without it, it feels a little bit lackluster, to be honest, but that's probably because I'm used to the high range of it. Personally, I think the 4 points are definitely well invested. Crescent Moon, oh boy, this skill is absolutely massive, but for Chaos Dungeons, it actually... I don't need it, surprisingly. Like, I was under the impression when I played Lancemaster for the first time, that this skill is like the utmost thing you can use. Turns out you don't actually need it. If you like it, you can mix and match your build around. I personally think the skill does absolutely fine without any tripods. Supposedly so, if you have 4 skills, 4 skill points left over, you could take any of these. All of them work just fine. The tornado is fun to look at, but it kind of messes up with my other skill rotations in Chaos Dungeons, so I personally don't use it. Ring of Light. Boy, this is definitely one, if not the most used skill and most beloved skill by me. I do have Chilling Cold, and I'll show you footage in just a second of why I'm using Chilling Cold here, because this will prevent like throwing the mobs all around, like all over the place, and you see that in just a second. Repeat Attack, personally I think this one is the best for Chaos Dungeons. Seizing the initiative is making it faster, but it reduces the radius quite a bit, so this one's an acceptable speed for me. And Ultimate Force just makes it very slow, and I don't like it. So I use Repeat Attack, and obviously Awakening Dragon, because we don't need Tenacity in Chaos Dungeons. So, Full Moon Strike. Now this is another skill that I don't see many people use. Personally, I think it's such a good tool for mobbing. It's my most loved skill on the moon stands. Super good to mob groups up, especially if you have the last tripod. The only downside is that it comes with a tripod at level 10, so it eats a lot of skill points, but super good skill. Strong Bonds, I have slow because we don't need concussion and we don't really have mana problems in Chaos Dungeons. Impressive Craftsmanship to increase damage by either 30% if you have hit one target, or by 20% if you hit 10 or more targets. Usually you hit more than 10 targets with this easily, and I'll show you just in a second how that looks like. In Touch of Death, like I said, is what makes this skill have these two activations. Super good skill. Absolutely awesome. Last argument actually isn't bad, but it just kind of removes the utility that I like from the skill. So I personally use this one for my Chaos Dungeons. Eclipse Path. Quickly prepare to have more cooldowns. Constant Threat allows you to channel the skill. Actually deals surprisingly good damage, especially if you get the lethal damage tripod. And if you channel this the whole duration with a moon buff on, this one's pretty heavy to hit. However, if you don't have enough skill points, this is probably one of the skills that I'd remove the earliest. Last but not least, Piercing Light. Quickly prepare for cooldown reduction and refined reflexes to have this one as a sort of instant skill. Because if you don't have that one, it's a little bit slow to use. It works fine in Chaos Dungeons, so if you don't have those skill points left over for refined reflexes, you're totally fine. Usually, this is only used to debuff bosses anyway. So you go to the boss, bam, debuff, so you have more crit chance against it, because that's the debuff the skill applies, and then you go ham whatever skills you want to use. This is all for the moon stance. Switching over to the sun stance, I do use 4 points in sunstroke, because this has a very short cooldown and is a good resource builder for me. You don't have to if you don't like using it, or if you don't have the 4 points, don't use it. Light Blades. We could use synergy here, but due to the fact that there's a lot of enemies around in Chaos Dungeons most of the time, I don't think it's needed. So I take Critical Threat in order to do some crits. You could alternatively use Dexterous Hands, but I don't think we need Dexterous Hands because we have Shadow Dance. And what Shadow Dance does is it leaves this shadowy afterimage. I'm not sure if you can see it. So there's like a red shadow that does the skill. And otherwise, you would actually have to stand still, right? I can't move during the whole animation, but Shadow Dance is just like, okay, let's leave it there. So definitely must take. And Deep Wounds, probably the best debuff you have for Lance Masters. Incredibly huge, it applies bleeding, and enemies at the base level take 20% more damage. You right now see 29.8% more damage because I have it on level 4 because of my tripods. Super good, super nice to increase your damage for awakening or other hard hitting skills. Definite must take. Scorching Wave. Now, I personally think Quickly Prepare is better for Chaos Dungeons than Dexterous Hands, but if you like to use it a little bit faster, go for it. I like to have it available more often. Critical Threat, same thing here. We don't really need a protective barrier, nor do we need destruction, so no point in really using it. And Wild Beast's Eye changes this one to a channel skill like this. You can even hold it a little bit. So as you can see, you can hold it for like, I don't know, it's like half a second. But usually you just release it when it's full. So boom, release. You can hear it like by the pling and this like sort of afterglow. Release it. But like I said, you can hold it a little bit. You can also freely aim, so I can do a 360 if I want to do. So definitely take those. Solar Eclipse, affected area, so we have a little bit of a better AoE. And again, I like to use more cooldown reduction for Chaos Dungeons. If you need more luminous energy, then use Synergy by all means. Last but not least, we do have Mantra of Dawn in the skill build, but there's no points in it here. Last but not least, we have Red Dragon Flight. Same thing applies here. I like using my skills more often, so I have cooldown reduction on it. You could alternatively use Power Balance to shoot the skill faster. Hold on, save. So this is what the skill looks like. You want to hit that. That was actually fail. You want to hit that sweet window here. The reason why I don't put more skill points to it is because the flawless execution requires you to hit with the spear tip. And the spear tip is actually this thing here. It's not actually her spear, but it's like the, if you will, the energy spear where my cursor is. I'm not sure if you can see that, right? So if we take flawless execution, let's summon a scarecrow so I can show you it. If we just stand behind it, we're gonna do like what, 93k, 92k, so it's probably gonna be like between 100 and 90k, something like that, 95-ish. If we were to hit with a spear tip, you can see that the crit damage is going to be even higher. But for Chaos Dungeons, most of the time you're not actually gonna be standing at optimal distance, but most of the time you're gonna be doing something like this, or what I do at least, boom. So there's not really a time where I get to use that flawless execution, so I personally think those skill points are more than enough. Anywho, last but not least, we talk about awakenings. I think there's no other way than to go to Milky Way, because yeah, takes a bit of a while to launch, but very good AoE, very high damage, and this one is pretty much a PvP or at least in my opinion, a PvP awakening. It's a lot easier to land on bosses, but damage output is, I think, not nearly as good enough. So you can actually cancel it prematurely. Like, you don't have to channel the full duration. However, I think it's definitely worth it to channel it the whole time. So yeah, for PvE, just use this one. Throw the spear, watch the explosion, and the damage fly. So for my raid and void build. So the first thing that you probably see a little bit different in most other guides is that I don't use double section. I just hate this skill. Sure, it's a good cooldown and it's a very good way to proc the bleed rune, but I personally just, I don't know, I just don't like it. So what I use instead is Skywheel, because I think this one looks cooler, deals better damage. The only downside is that it actually is a headshot, so you have to use it from the front in order to get a damage bonus. This one has a back attack, but this is a personal choice. This is something that you can switch around because it's not going to be making or breaking your build. There's plenty of other skills or places where you can move around some skill points. This is definitely the least important one. It's just a personal preference thing. I prefer this one. With that out of the way, Moonblade Fury. You've seen that one in the Chaos build. Same deal here. Swift Throw and my Bleed Rune is their Flying Blue Dragon. Same rule here. Just used as a resource builder. Descent of the Moon, exactly the same as well. Mobility tool, you want to move around faster. Crescent Moon, this one's going to be the first difference. I use Impressive Craftsmanship because most of the time it's going to be one boss. So you're going to get a 26% damage increase. You could use the other ones, but I think this one's just the best choice overall that you can pick there, especially for raids, because most of the time you're going to hit one target at the end. So you get the full 26% damage increase. Ring of Light is going to be working different. We use Quickly Prepare to have it more often. We don't need a freeze or a burn on raid bosses. Seizing the Initiative, you definitely want this skill to be faster because, you know, it's all about getting your opportunities or window of opportunities and hitting as hard as you can during those times. So this one definitely helps. And Awakening Dragon, we want the maximized damage here. So Skywheel, like I said, boy, I just love this skill. It looks cool, it sounds cool, it just feels nice. It's unfortunately not the best skill. However, if you actually decide to max it all the way and do Find Weakness and Furious Pressure, the skill is actually pretty cool. So I like it. Personally, most of the time, I'm just going to be lumping around with this one here. So Eclipse Path, same thing here. It's going to be degraded to a resource builder because we don't really have the constant threat time. Rather, it's not like Chaos Dungeons where you have like the 2 seconds to channel the full thing. There are windows to do that, but you're generally better off using different skills because the timings are going to be much shorter. So you just use this as a resource builder. It's going to be faster this way. If you so desire, obviously, you could go for attack speed because this one's going to be better off than constant threat. Last but not least, Piercing Light, cooldown reduction, no explanations needed. Refined Reflexes, because we want to have this one instantly. And we want Serious Vulnerability, because this one gives us an additional 10% crit rate. So this one debuffs the enemy, so you have 8% higher crit chance, and if you have the Serious Vulnerability, it's going to be 18%. So take a look at this one here, 18% crit. If we don't have it, wait for it to run out. There we go, it's only going to be 8%. So this one's pretty massive. Definitely a taker. So Sunstroke, basically the same rule here as for Chaos Dungeons. I use it to build synergies or your resource meter. But if you need those for a skill point somewhere else, take them out. Definitely not needed. Light Blades, same thing here. You want Critical Threat for more damage. Shadow Dance so you can move around. We don't want to stand still for too long. And we have Deep Wounds to increase the damage the boss will take afterwards. Scorching Wave, now we have Find Weakness and not Quickly Prepare because we want to deal more damage to the boss. Critical Threat again, we want to deal crits, and Wild Beast's Eye, same rule here. You want this skill to crit and just whack the boss with it. As you can see here, guaranteed crits, super good. If you use it point blank, not everything is going to be, but perfectly fine. Solar Eclipse, Find Weakness, because we don't actually need the area, because the boss is big enough. So you're going to be hitting him. You should be. Quickly prepare, just like anything else. You could use concussion if you wanted to, but I think this one definitely benefits because the cooldown reduction on this tripod is pretty huge. And we want compressed ring, so it turns to be like a purple thing. This one's gonna be dealing 100% more damage to... no, it's gonna be a guaranteed crit against targets that are immune to stun and knockback, which means pretty much any raid boss, so you're gonna be dealing a guaranteed crit. You can see where this is going here. Last but not least, Red Dragonflight. Quickly prepare. I like this to have more cooldown though. Destructive power, guaranteed crit. We don't use flawless execution, but we use find weakness. The same rule that I showed you in Chaos Dungeons apply here. There are obviously sometimes windows where we can actually get to land this one. But this one here just always flat deals more damage. It's just the way it is. So personally, I think just take this one because it makes it so much easier. Most of the time you're going to be doing something like this, like debuff the enemy, slap this one in, slap that one in. You're not going to be moving around constantly to position yourself to get that extra damage. So I think this one is a much better pick when it comes to Red Dragon Flight. All right, and that's it pretty much for my raid build as well. Ultimate, like I said, no explanation needed. Debuff, place it. Watch the damage fly, and that's it. Obviously, it needs a little bit of a setup, so you gotta know what the bosses can do. Either you're gonna wait for a knockdown phase, an impairment phase, or something like that. Or if you're comfortable, you know what the moves are. Just slow, like, just throw it in, and you'll see how it goes. Anywho, this is all that I wanted to give you guys for my Lancemaster builds. Like I said, I use Superiority of the Stars. If you use Full Moon Kick, then sorry, this build ain't gonna work for you. But for anybody else, this is it. Last but not least, I do stream Monday 1700 CST. So if you want to see me live on Twitch playing Lost Ark and other games, be free to shoot me a message there or check out my channel in the description below. As far as the rest goes, if you have any questions, anything is unclear, check out the description below for any more details, a table of contents, or just put a comment in the comment section down below and I'll gladly answer any questions you may have. So stay safe, stay healthy out there, and I'll see you guys next time.